one thing we need to do before we get too much further is we need to observe this store and tell it that, hey, anytime this changes, we need to re-render. You get that from the observer higher order function from MobX React Lite. And what I'll do here is I will actually observer, I will wrap around the function right there, and we're done. It will actually observe, it'll recognize that this is a MobX state tree store that's being accessed, and any properties that are accessed within it will then be observed.
Is observer?
So observer basically is a function that will take a React function component, like a functional component, and return another functional component that's smarter and will be essentially anytime it renders, it's watching, it's paying attention what properties are being accessed. Now, in new versions of MobX, it does that using a proxy object. In older versions, it used like getters. And so you could basically just know when, hey, dot players is accessed. So anytime dot players changes, I need to re-render this guy, this particular component. It's a little magic, but it works. And so it's kind of fantastic to just be able to wrap that. And now it's live. It's watching and it's re-rendering anytime that happens.
Okay. All right.
So the other thing we wanted to do was to be able to make a, you know, to click basically and mm-hmm. have it, you know, right now, if I click, nothing's happening. So we want to be able to change some of the data. Before we do that, though, this is something I should have done in the previous demo, but I'm going to go ahead and pull it out right here. Let's grab a function, which is just a player itself, and we'll get a player from in the properties. We're going to return this data right here. So, whoops, this needs to be in curly. So all I'm doing is creating a little sub component here that will render the player. And if I put this in here, again, we're using JSX, player equals player. And if I refresh over here, there should be no changes. It should just, let me refresh the whole screen just to make sure that worked.
It looked like it worked. Of course,
it worked.
It's always a little disconcerting. Like if the update didn't make any changes, there's no changes, like, okay, did it work?
Did it work? Exactly.
It's like writing a test the first time, a unit test the first time and having it pass. Like, okay, did I actually write this correctly?
Let's see. It's giving me some warnings here, but I don't think that should matter. Yeah, it doesn't actually look like it's re-rendering here. So, okay, we've got a sandbox. Okay, so while that's hopefully, oh, there we go, boom. All right, that finished. Okay, just a little code sandbox glitch there. So
just enough to make you nervous.
Just enough to make me nervous, exactly. Now, one thing we do have to do is make sure that anything that is that has any component that is accessing any sort of MobX state tree like model at all needs to be wrapped in observer. So I can't actually do this right here. What I need to do is do const player equals observer so we can kind of wrap this, right? And then just make this a function. So it's very similar. It's still kind of the same thing, but we're wrapping the player in an observer again. So this makes this smart. So now remember how I said if player store.players changes, like if that changes at all, it will re-render.
Mm-hmm.
Now this is doing the same thing here, but with player.name and player.imageURL. If either of those change, then just that one instance, that one component will re-render.
So it doesn't have to do the full array. It can then just do that one individual player.
Exactly. Okay. And that's kind of the power of this, because it can sit there and just monitor like individual properties, and only when those change it triggers a re-render.
Okay.
So we want to actually do something with this, right? So let me go back to our store for a second. And remember in the last one, we were kind of loop. Actually, I'll show you. we were looping through like this guy right here. Let me actually, so we're looping through all of the players, finding the right one, and then changing the name by returning like a new object here. We don't have to do that with MobX State Tree. I'm just going to delete that. In MobX State Tree, what we will do is...
My least favorite bit of code.
Yes, it's gone. So again, an action. You can do this on models or on stores. Again, they're the same thing, more or less. So in this case, we're getting a player back, right? Mm-hmm. And so then I'm going to define an action here, and that's going to be set name. And we're going to get a new name. And that will just be a string. And we're just going to say player.name equals new name. There should be more to this, right? But there's not. That's it.
That's wonder that, but that's exactly what I want. Like when I'm working with an array, that's exactly what I want. It's like, hey, I've got a new item. Just update this one thing.
One thing. Dot notation equals, it's wonderful. So what we're doing here is we need to call that. So what do we do? Player.setName. And we're going to make them all Jamon again. So let's hit refresh over here. Make sure we have everything newly loaded.
At this point, while we were recording, we had some technical issues. Let's come back. So where we left our hero was we had just gone in. We had created that little set name action. Mm-hmm. And then you had just gone in and added that into to the link there.
Yes, exactly. And so now it's all wired up. It will, you can set the name. It will re-render just this component, player.name, without re-rendering the whole thing, which is fantastic. We are not using useState anymore.